Hi, welcome to my channel. In this video, we want to solve the following problem. Let A, B, and CD be chords of a circle with center O. Given that AB equals 32 units, CD equals 132 units, and angle COD equals 5 times angle AOB, our goal is to find the radius of the circle. And now for the solution. First, let's focus on triangle AOB. Recall that the perpendicular bisector of a chord passes through the center of the circle. So let's construct the perpendicular from O to AB and label the foot of the perpendicular as E. Since the length of AB is 32 units, the length of EB equals 32 divided by 2, or 16 units. Next, focus on triangle EOB. Let's call the radius of the circle and thus the length of OB as R, and denote angle EOB, which is this angle, as theta. Then since triangle EOB is a right-angled triangle, we have sine theta equals 16 over R, or sine theta over 16 equals 1 over R. Next, let's focus on triangle COD. Again, we construct the perpendicular from O to CD and label the foot of the perpendicular as F. Since the length of CD is 122 units, the length of FD equals 122 divided by 2, or 61 units. Following this, focus on triangle FOD. Since OD is a radius of the circle, its length is R. Next, let's express angle FOD, which is this angle, in terms of theta. To do this, consider triangles COD and AOB. Since length of OC is R, triangle COD is an isosceles triangle. The perpendicular OF bisects angle COD. Thus, angle FOD equals half times angle COD. Similarly, OE bisects angle AOB. So angle AOB equals 2 theta. Given that angle COD equals 5 times angle AOB, angle FOD equals half times 5 times angle AOB, or half times 5 times 2 theta. Therefore, angle FOD equals 5 theta. Turning back to triangle FOD, since the triangle is a right-angled triangle, we have sine 5 theta equals 61 over R, or sine 5 theta over 61 equals 1 over R. Therefore, we have sine 5 theta over 61 equals sine theta over 16. Next, let's prove the identity sine 5 theta equals 16 sine theta to the power of 5 minus 20 sine theta cubed plus 5 sine theta. To do that, we write sine 5 theta as sine of theta plus 4 theta and apply the angle addition formula sine of A plus B equals sine A times cosine B plus cosine A times sine B to obtain sine theta times cosine 4 theta plus cosine theta times sine 4 theta. Next, let's express cosine 4 theta in terms of sine theta. To aid us, we should make use of these identities. First, we use this identity to write cosine 4 theta as 2 cosine 2 theta whole square minus 1, and then use this identity to write cosine 2 theta as 1 minus 2 sine theta square. Then we expand the brackets using the identity a minus b whole square equals a square minus 2ab plus b square to obtain 2 times 1 minus 4 sine theta square plus 4 sine theta to the power of 4 minus 1, which simplifies to 8 sine theta to the power of 4 minus 8 sine theta squared plus 1. Substituting this into the expression for sine 5 theta and then simplifying, we obtain 8 sine theta to the power of 5 minus 8 sine theta cubed plus sine theta plus cosine theta times sine 4 theta. Next, let's simplify sine 4 theta. Using this identity, we write sine 4 theta as 2 sine 2 theta times cosine 2 theta, and then use the same identity to write sine 2 theta as 2 sine theta times cosine theta. Then we use this identity to write cosine 2 theta as 1 minus 2 sine theta squared. Simplifying the overall expression then gives us cosine theta times 4 sine theta minus 8 sine theta cubed. Multiplying cosine theta with sine 4 theta gives us cosine theta squared times 4 sine theta minus 8 sine theta cubed. Then writing cosine theta squared as 1 minus sine theta squared and expanding the resulting bracket gives us 4 sine theta minus 8 sine theta cubed minus 4 sine theta cubed plus 8 sine theta to the power of 5, or 8 sine theta to the power of 5 minus 12 sine theta cubed plus 4 sine theta. Substituting this into the expression for sine 5 theta and combining like terms, you obtain 16 sine theta to the power of 5 minus 20 sine theta cubed plus 5 sine theta, thus verifying the identity. Our equation thus becomes 16 sine theta to the power of 5 minus 20 sine theta cubed plus 5 sine theta over 61 equals sine theta over 16. Since sine theta over 16 equals 1 over r, we have r sine theta equals 16. Thus sine theta is greater than 0. Therefore, let's multiply both sides by 16 times 61 over sine theta. For the left hand side, we observe that 61 cancels out. Multiplying the first term with 16 over sine theta gives us 16 squared sine theta to the power of 4. While the second term gives us minus 20 times 16 sine theta squared, and the third term gives us 80. For the right hand side, sine theta and 16 cancels out, leaving us with 61. Our equation then becomes 16 squared sine theta to the power of 4 minus 20 times 16 sine theta squared plus 19 equals 0. 16 squared sine theta to the power of 4 can be written as 16 sine theta squared whole square. By substituting t equals 16 sine theta squared, we transform the equation into t squared minus 20t plus 19 equals 0. Solving this equation by factorization, we obtain t equals 19 or t equals 1. Noting our substitution, when t equals 19, we have 16 sine theta squared equals 19, or sine theta squared equals 19 over 16. So sine theta equals square root 19 over 4, which is greater than 1. But this is impossible, since sine theta must be less than or equal to 1. Thus, we reject t equals 19 and conclude that t equals 1. When t equals 1, we have 16 sine theta squared equals 1, or sine theta squared equals 1 over 16. So sine theta equals 1 over 4. Substituting this into sine theta over 16 equals 1 over r, we obtain 1 over 4 times 16 equals 1 over r, or 1 over 64 equals 1 over r. Cross multiplying, we obtain r equals 64, which is a solution to our problem. As an exercise, try to solve this problem and see if you can get the correct answer. This marks the end of the video. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more content. Thanks for watching, and see you all next time.